very early in the morning. I came by bus.
The event started up at Deptford, up at New Cross.
At the time, I was a serving police officer in Lewisham, and I was part of the history of Lewisham myself because I was the first black police officer to serve in the borough.
I met friends here who were living in Lewisham, and we all came together in a big group. We were the first ones in the waiting for the demonstration to start.
Leading up to the demonstration and disturbances, there was a lot of debate. All of these people were very instrumental in appealing to the police commissioner and the then Home Secretary to basically not to allow a march through Lewisham. But I think the position of the police commissioner and the Home Secretary was that because of the traditions in this country of freedom of movement, freedom of expression, that they thought the march ought to go ahead.
Here in Lewisham, on that side of the road, in Brockley and New Cross, a very large black community, but on all the other sides, the communities were almost completely white. And so, see the significance of the National Front marching against the black people.
And on the day of the demonstration, we decided we wanted to challenge and stop the National Front marching the streets of Lewisham.
Sea of people, there was nowhere to clear anybody to.
Five different police were kicked me like a ball, and then I was threatened with arrest.
The police moved the National Front out of the way. The National Front went home. We didn't see the National Front again. They sort of marched from New Cross towards Lewisham Station. We never saw them again.
The violence, the fear, people being hurt, running away, trying to find some safety and not finding one.
I can say from my own, to my own knowledge and experience, I heard police officers say things which sounded as though, on occasion, I had some, I emphasise, say some things that would give the impression that they would be sympathetic to the National Front.
It was chaos. Just vivid memories of fear, terror, blood and violence from the police.
Honestly, don't think people envisaged that it would have ended in, well, the level of disorder that it did.
I didn't think of it as a historic day. I didn't realise until later that the National Front said that we'd broken their back in Lewisham by actually stopping them. Until then, they could do things with impunity.
But very importantly, Lewisham is a borough where at the drop of a hat, things are not likely to go off in a tinderbox like many other places. And I think that goes back to the strong unity that was built up around the time of the disorders and the march to say no to the National Front.